In today's tutorial, we're going to be creating this retro glitch effect in Adobe Photoshop. For this, we're going to be using tools and effects such as RGB splitting, analogue scan lines, the displacement tool, and more. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be creating your own glitch effects like a pro. So I'm going to be working on this image of a spaceman, but you can follow the steps and apply this to any image. So to begin, let's open our layers panel and create a copy of our image using Command C to copy and Command V to paste. And I'm going to call this layer Spaceman RGB Split. Next, if you double click this layer, it's going to bring up the layer style panel. And next to channels, we're going to deselect red and green and hit OK. Now hold shift and use your arrow key to nudge the image and you'll see we have created this RGB split effect. You can play around with what channels you have selected to get different effects. Now, we want to add a glitch textured image like this one. I found mine on Adobe Stock by typing in glitch effect. You can use this image too by searching the image name here, and I'll also put the link in the description. There are also lots of free alternatives online as well. So after you've found your image, we're going to go File, Place Linked, and drop our image in. Reduce the opacity down to 50% so you can see your image behind. Now hit Command T to transform it, and we can scale and reposition it to where we want to distort our image. When you're happy, increase the opacity back to 100%. Right click and rasterize this layer. Now we want to crop it to the artboard. So with your layer selected, choose the crop tool, click enter and check that you have delete cropped pixels selected. Then click enter again to crop. Again, right click your layer and convert it to a smart object. Double click the thumbnail to open it in a new tab. We now need to convert our glitch image into a high contrast black and white image. So first, let's add a black and white adjustment layer. Then, add levels, and we're going to drag the white slider up until the whites are nice and bright and have a good contrast with the black. Save this as a .psd file, and then we can close it and delete this layer. Now, with your RGB split layer selected, go up to Filter and down to Distort, Displace. We're going to adjust the horizontal scale to 30 and the vertical to 10. Then hit OK, select the PSD file you just created, and repeat these steps for the other layer. This time I will use 20 for the horizontal and 0 for vertical. You can nudge the RGB split layer to create a more distorted look. Finally, we're going to add the analog scan lines. So create a new layer. With white selected, hold Alt Delete to color the layer. Now go up to Filter, Filter Gallery, select the halftone pattern effect, and change the pattern type to line. You can adjust the size and contrast, then hit OK when you're happy. Change the blend mode to overlay, and reduce the opacity down to 50%. A final adjustment to achieve that retro look, select the curves adjustment, click to add a center point, and then drag this point up, which is going to fade our blacks to create this retro look. And there we have it. Give this a try and see what you can create. As always, thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, be sure to like and subscribe, and leave me a comment of any tutorials you want to see next. See you next time.